sipping on my sangria, soaking in the stimuli, flexing on the patio. Sun. Hello, Ants Canada friends, everybody on YouTube, Ant lovers of the world. Today was a special opportunity for the store because, well, I've been waiting for the longest time to create this video on how to attach an attachment to an already grown colony. Our favorite Tetramorium colony right here in the very first pumice nest ever invented. There it is, and there they are. They're all packed in there. You see that? There's no space. When they get to this point, this is when you have to add an attachment or move them to a new formicarium. Now in this case, we are going to add an attachment. I still would like them to have this pumice nest space to live in. As you can see here, they've already begun piling the brood into the tube, which leads into the outworld, which is not good. You know, telltale sign that it's time to add an addition. So, here is our new nest. It's a small black habitat nest with its two openings. I've got a half inch diameter tubing leading from the back, which will lead into the pumice nest, and another one at the back, which is attached to a small, with a smaller quarter inch wires to remove this tube here and attach it to that, so then they can all discover the new nest. You'll need a piece of cotton with tape, like so, on hand. And what this is for is, once you separate that tube, you want to slap this on to that outworld so that the ants that are in the outworld can't escape. And you got to be quick about it too, otherwise you'll get escapees. So right now they're all calm, it's nighttime. Hydrate the nest there. Let's add some water toward the habitat nest, kind of close to where they will be making their first appearance. I had watered this nest already yesterday, so still fairly moist, but let's go ahead and make it much more tantalizing for them. Here we go. First things first, detach the tube and attach it to this tube, and then we're going to want to put this cotton onto the hole there. Wish me luck, guys. Here we go. I'm actually kind of scared. I don't know how. No. Okay, that was harder than I thought. You know what I'm gonna do? I know what I'm gonna do. You kind of only have one shot to do this. I don't want to squish any ants. I'm gonna use some of these. Okay, now they're nice and alarmed. You quickly attach the tubing to this tubing here. And I already have an escaped ant. Then you place the cotton to block this hole. Done. See that? Now, I had trouble pulling. I've got Tetramorium ants crawling all over my pliers here. Sorry, buddy. Sorry, babe. I gotta put you in here. Every ant counts. I do not allow any ants to die unnecessarily. So the ants are starting to discover the new tube. They're in there, you see. They're gonna continue up into the formicarium. And as for this outworld here, I can now go on and attempt to attach it to the formicarium on the other end. There's a Tetramorium right now. Oh. They've begun exploring the habitat nest. Okay, so now in terms of this end, I gotta really plan this because I cut the end of that off. So another option would be to remove this piece here. Remove that piece there and simply attach the outworld to there. You see, when working with ants, you gotta work quickly. Think quickly, work quickly, and invent plan C quickly. Oh, no, the ants are coming out. Okay. Sorry, babes. Gotta attach you to your family here. Any escapees? No, I don't think so. Good, good, good. Done. And now they're attached to their outworld. Those ants that were in the outworld that were hoping to get home will be climbing up this tube. And once they meet their family on the other side, all will be well. So this is the aftermath of the move. It's been a few minutes and the Tetramoriums have already begun digging and customizing the space. I'm pretty sure the move will happen very soon. I've got them there. As you can see, I've basically I've elevated both units here to be on the same level in terms of the tubing, because the ants seem to be slipping off the tubing. So, you know, if you notice your ants don't climb the tubes well, you can just elevate. Yeah, yeah. They're going to love this new home. And there's a lot more space for them too. You can place this over the nest, just so it'll be nice and dark for them to encourage them to move. You might be asking what this black cable is here. This black cable is a reptile heating cable. You only need to sling it across the top. It only needs to come in contact with the nest at two locations for those who have a pumice nest, and the ants will place the pupae at just the right distance. Even a 15 watt can be kind of hot, a little too hot for them, but if it comes in contact with just one or two areas, they basically bring all the pupae close to it. Now the queen is somewhere in here, pretty sure. All those workers are in there. There we go. A successful move.